Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am so excited that you guys are here, and I hope that you are having an absolutely fantastic morning, afternoon, or night, whatever it is for you when this video finally reaches you. You guys, today's video is one that I am so excited to get into because number one, we are diving into yet another haunted doll. And if you guys have been here on my channel for a while, you guys would know that I love looking into, hearing about, learning about, and meeting some of the world's most haunted dolls. But this video is extra special because today we're diving into a haunted doll that one of you guys had an encounter with. I actually received this email a couple of days ago and I wound up kind of like skimming through the email and I had absolute chills and just knew that I had to share it with you guys on here because I love hearing all of your thoughts and opinions. And beyond that, it always fascinates me to hear your guys' stories because I feel like more often than not, we get so caught up in like the world famous haunted dolls. Like you guys know, I've met Annabelle the haunted doll that inspired the Conjuring film Annabelle. I mean, there's a few of them, but you know what I mean. And I love talking about them, but it's always fascinating to dive into the fact that there are people living, you know, regular lives, bringing dolls into their environment, into their home, into their life, that wind up getting more than they bargained for. Except in today's story, we're talking about a haunted doll that was purchased online. So there was intent behind it. They didn't accidentally stumble upon this doll, and they're advising people to never buy a haunted doll online. So I'm really excited to share this story with you guys, hear your guys' experiences, and more importantly, your thoughts and opinions on this particular haunting. Before we get into today's video though, I would just very quickly like to thank today's video sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people. With Skillshare, you can explore new skills, develop existing interests, and just overall get completely lost in creativity. Whether you're looking to fend off boredom or practice self-care through creativity, or even if you just want to join a similarly creative community, Skillshare is the place to keep you learning. A class that I'm looking to get into next is a video for Instagram, Tell an Engaging Story in Less Than a Minute, which is taught by Hollies. But no matter what it is that you're interested in, I know Skillshare will have a class for you. I've taken classes on there from like podcasting to how to take care of houseplants to how to like expand my culinary skills and now to do with telling engaging stories on Instagram. So whatever it is that you're looking to get into, I know Skillshare will have the perfect class for you. What's really exciting is the first 1,000 people to click the link down in my description will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. And then after that, it's just around $10 a month. So make sure that you guys click the link down in my description so you are within the first 1,000 people. And yeah, thank you so much to Skillshare for not only expanding my creative mind, but also sponsoring today's video. But without further ado, let's get into this particular experience because as I mentioned, it is absolutely chilling. So the email was titled, "My Family's Warning, Never Buy a Haunted Doll Online." And it goes like this. Dear Haley, I hope this email finds you well. My name is Carol, and I'm from a tiny town in the US. I'm a widow and a mother of two girls. I always knew my oldest daughter was special. She had a gift, if you will, from a very young age. She never shied away from sharing it either. When she was just 5 years old, she told her teacher that her mother, whom my child had no idea was deceased, had a message for her. Turns out, she was channeling the dead, something she would do quite frequently. As she got older, she got more and more fascinated with the dead. She explained it as they would call to her and she was always willing to answer. I would ask her often if she was afraid, but she wasn't. To me, it seemed like she was almost addicted to death and the other side, but I knew what she was doing was legit. I never worried if it was something I had to worry about with her mentally. A few years ago, things would take an interesting turn. News of haunted dolls and haunted items got popular. My daughter was obsessed with the idea of souls or entities being inside of dolls and objects. She even told me that she just had to have one. Initially, I was completely against the idea. My youngest daughter was also terrified of the idea, and to be quite honest, I just didn't know what to think. But day in and day out, my daughter looked online for what she described as her perfect haunted doll. One day, she was looking online and I decided to sit down next to her to see what this was all about. As she continued scrolling, I couldn't believe the prices. I told my daughter I was pretty sure people were just buying random dolls and listing them as haunted and tripling the price. But my daughter just laughed. She told me she would know when it was the right doll for her and that the price would be just right. She said that whispers in her ears told her, and that was why she kept looking every single day, waiting for the right one. And she did. Haley, when I tell you my daughter looked every single day for 2 years, I mean it. It got to a point that even I thought that we'd never actually end up with one. I thought she was just enjoying looking around online for one and didn't actually want one. But I was wrong. One day out of the blue, my daughter came running up to me asking me to look at her iPad. On it, she had a picture of a very normal looking porcelain doll. The doll's name was Violet, and to my surprise, she was listed for just one single dollar. The bio was long and detailed of terrifying events caused by Violet. Whoever was listing her was fully transparent in the fact she didn't want the doll anymore and needed it gone. She said the doll had destroyed her marriage, her health, and was slowly but surely destroying every element of her life. I looked at my daughter in shock. Why the hell would she want this doll? But my daughter smiled, told me that the whispers say this is the one, that she needs it. My biggest mistake was saying yes to that doll. I guess part of me figured it was only a dollar. What did I have to lose? And to be honest, at this point, I thought it was still a bunch of bull anyways. So we ordered Violet, and eventually, that doll was in our home. The first few weeks weren't notable. My daughter and Violet became inseparable faster than I could have even imagined, and it seemed as though all was well. I still didn't believe Violet had any sort of entity or whatever they called it in her, but my daughter was happy. She stopped looking online for haunted dolls and decided to put all her energy into Violet. I asked my daughter what the deal with this doll was, and my daughter told me that the lady that we got her from had it all wrong. So the spirit was of a sad woman, a woman who never had love in her life, was abused and tortured, that all she wanted was to be loved. My daughter said that when the soul died, her soul couldn't move on, but instead went into this doll, hoping to be loved and cherished. But that never happened. Again, I didn't necessarily believe this tale, but my daughter did, and that was all that mattered at the time. Soon my daughter started changing. She became disconnected, angry, and nothing like the child that I once knew. Her bond with the doll got stronger until it was the only one she had. My daughter started getting sick, started lashing out, and eventually was hospitalized with an undiagnosed sickness. It was around this time that I started having horrible dreams that centered around Violet. She was in the hospital room with my daughter. In some dreams, she was choking her. In others, she was on fire next to her. When I would wake up from these dreams, as unbelievable as it sounds, I would have unexplainable scratches all over my body. For months, my daughter was in and out of the hospital. We lost our house because of piling debt, and it seemed like a sudden dark cloud was over my life. For a minute, I questioned my own sanity as I was thinking that maybe Violet actually had something to do with all of this. But that didn't make sense to me. It was a stupid doll, and I didn't believe that it was even real. I ended up reaching out to a medium a few towns over after my friends were listening to everything happening and advised me to. I was looking for answers, and with that, the darkness came to light. This woman was gifted. She knew things about my life that you couldn't even imagine, even the fact that my child had a thinner veil, as she described it, between our world and theirs. The woman told me that the doll my daughter had latched onto wasn't just a doll. She said that it wasn't even a spirit. She said it was a dark force, a dark entity, a violent soul collector, one that pushes people to a breaking point until they're too weak to protect themselves. Even more terrifying, at one point, the woman kept repeating, "Violent, violent, violent," over and over again. And it was then that I realized the doll wasn't named Violet. It was Violent. To make a long story short, it took several weeks to properly get rid of the doll, and the residual energy lasted longer than I'd like to admit. But eventually, my daughter's health regained and life did get better. My daughter said she will never buy another haunted doll again, and that she doesn't think anyone should. She believes that Violet called out to her long before she even found the listing. You're probably wondering why I'm sending this to you. In my quest for answers, I found your many videos of haunted dolls online and wanted to share our experience. I know people probably won't believe it, but it's the truth. It's our truth, and we went through it. And if I can save even just one person from buying a haunted doll online, I can sleep happily. Thank you for hearing my story. You're more than welcome to share it. It's real, and it's true. Okay, so I have a couple of questions when it comes to this story, starting with the fact that her daughter was very open to the other side. So it almost surprises me that she didn't recognize that it was a darker entity or spirit when she saw the doll and then had the doll in her possession. It almost makes you believe that the daughter was completely manipulated by whatever was within the doll. Secondly, I wonder how the initial owner that they got it from came up with the name Violet when the medium says it was Violent. I almost wonder, like, did she hear it? Did she perhaps have a spirit box? I don't know, I'd love to know your guys' thoughts on that as well. I also wish that she would have specified what she had to do to get rid of the doll and what that process looked like. But ultimately, that is the experience. And I'm so freaking curious to read through this comment section and hear from you guys what on earth you guys think happened. Do you think this was a true experience? Do you believe that there was a doll named Violet or Violent out there that caused this amount of harm to a family? Do you think the sickness and whatnot was coincidental? I want to hear all of your thoughts down in the comment section below. I will 100% be reading through these comments because I love hearing your guys' theories, and I'm very curious to know what it is that you guys think of this one. But ultimately, that is it for today's video. Once again, I would just love to thank Skillshare for sponsoring this video. As I mentioned, the first 1,000 of you to click the link down in my description box will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership, and then it's just $10 a month after that, so make sure you click that link. If you guys are new to my channel or you are just not yet subscribed but you do enjoy my content, I would seriously love it if you would go ahead and click that subscribe button, and please give this video a big thumbs up if you did enjoy it. Remember, my loves, do all things with kindness, and until next time, I love you.